Ajay Game Reserve, named after Chief Ajay's palace, became a sanctuary in 1965, by then hosting 60 of the 80 remaining white rhinos in Uganda. It was established on 166 square kilometers land, but UWA is currently seeking for more land from the community to expand the area to host white rhinos. The Speaker of Madiokolo District, Faima Letiru, together with the council, approved the need to reintroduce white rhinos, with hopes for the district to benefit economically and increase its tax base with better tourism potential.
Not limited to Pakwats, Rhino Camp, Dufule Road, but also other district roads. And I think the response has been given here ably, that you now, as a district, we are going to be given a grader. So I think this is a very big contribution from UWA, and we are very grateful. Employment opportunity for all the Madi people, not only limited to the affected community.
The first tourism potential that is nearly an attraction is Ajay Wildlife Reserve. We intend to have numerous activities like game viewing. We have hiking, like at Ombi Hill, where there are two crater lakes, man and woman. We have Eremba Hill, which had been a communication booster point.
John Makobo, the director conservation at Uganda Wildlife Authority, said consultations were done with the community to seek for more land to expand Ajay Game Reserve to host the white rhinos.
Okay, for now we have got 166 square kilometers, but the rhino is a lowland feeder. You don't expect the rhino to climb hills, mountains, but because of these additional landscapes, these land features which cannot favor their existence in this, that's why we are actually looking for more land.
The existing Ajay Game Reserve land was leased in 1964, and the community has agreed to the terms of reintroduction of the white rhinos. Affected community members will be compensated after thorough assessment. The various historical and cultural sites will be reserved, and the affected persons will be compensated. Reintroduction of the white rhinos will lead to diversion of the Pakwats Madiokolo Road connecting to Arua of about 38 kilometers.
The compensation is going to handle the people who are within the reserve. Initially, we have 11 families, but since the reserve was regazetted in 2002, it's now over 20 years, meaning that the person who is a child at that time has actually grown and is now a household person. So we already have some little data, but we're going to make an assessment, proper assessment, when we are doing the survey, and know now how many households are there to be compensated. Because
some of the councillors expressed their views on the benefit the district will gain from the reintroduction of the white rhinos in Ajay Game Reserve.
The tourism aspect of it, and I strongly believe having these wild animals here, or the rhinos, will attract more tourists. We're all aware that Madiokolo has only 1% local revenue.
Community benefit will be when they have set businesses on ground where these white rhinos are going to be introduced. That is our anticipation, and that is what we're expecting from the introduction of the rhinos to the district.
The habitat has changed over time. Can it still be suitable? And they can't really test it with all of them at once.
The community in Onyom, Olali and Odraka are among those affected in the quest for more land. The government valuer will be brought to value the affected community members' land, and by July 2024, the compensation will start. Other animals to be reintroduced to Ajay Game Reserve include Uganda cob, buffaloes, among others. UWA expects to see the white rhinos in Madiokolo by mid-2025. Report compiled by Robert Ariaka for the news.